everybody. This is 22 Tiger Dude here, and I'm here to review A Nightmare on Elm Street. Before I review this film, Calob is going to review this movie. So, Calob, my man, take it away.
Hey guys, what's going on? I'm Calob, and thank you, 22 Tiger Dude, for letting me collaborate with you in this way. I love your channel, and I hope your people will come check out my channel. I do movie reviews and movie-related videos all the time. I'm currently at 45 subscribers, and I want to boost that so much. I'm so proud of my channel, and I hope you guys will like the content I can provide. Hopefully, there'll be a link in the description. If not, just type in Calob on YouTube and check me out. Anyways, today's review is A Nightmare on Elm Street, the original. It's a classic. Everybody's heard of it. It's such an amazing horror movie. Wes Craven is actually one of my favorite horror directors. He's made films like the original Hills Have Eyes, believe it or not. All four Screams and this one. He's made a few mistakes in the past, My Soul to Take and stuff like that. But generally, I love the guy. He's a very good director and he knows what he's doing most of the time. One of my biggest positives about this film is Robert Englund is Freddy Krueger. In this time, we had a bunch of different people play Jason and a bunch of different people play Michael Myers. But Robert Englund stayed. He was Freddy Krueger the whole run of this series, and he deserves every bit of respect you could give somebody like him. He is so expressive with Freddy Krueger. He, for instance, when he moves at the beginning and he's chasing the girl at the beginning, sorry, I was wiping my nose. When he chases the girl at the beginning of the film, it's creepy as crap just the way he moves, and that's not even any dialogue. And then once he actually does say his dialogue, oh, get your new underwear ready, because he is even creepier when he starts talking. He's just the best possible person to play Freddy Krueger, and it helps me forget about how bad the performance of Rorschach, or whatever the crap the guy's name is, from Watchmen's performance in the rebooted Nightmare on Elm Street. Of course, that's just my opinion. I hate that movie like the plague, but that's just my opinion. Anyway, now, I'm probably going to butcher this lady's name, but let's see. Heather Langenkamp, aka the girl who plays Nancy, does an incredible job in this movie. And this is what really invented it's now a stereotype, but it's kind of what invented the girl being the biggest human character in the movie. And I really like, it's kind of a twist actually, because at the beginning, the girl who's getting chased by Freddy, you, for some reason, it just is in your brain that you would think that that's the main character. Well, let me just say, I'm not going to spoil anything, but let's just say she's not. Nancy is the main character, and she is awesome. We also get a role from Johnny Depp, and believe it or not, this is actually his first role in a movie, and he's very likable, and it's a positive because it's just kind of cool to see somebody like Johnny Depp in an independent horror movie like this, so young, and it's just funny. It's funny but freaky. His scene where he dies is by far one of the best horror scenes ever. I just love it so freaking much. The scares in this movie, holy crap. I don't have the exact date when this movie was released, but I know it was way back. And the fact that the scares hold up today is beyond me. Me and my brother actually just watched this a couple nights ago, and I was freaked out. And I've already seen it a bunch of times, but I was still freaked out because just the cinematography and the direction by Wes Craven, it's all perfect. The script is amazing also. And the runtime for the movie is perfect too. Like, I didn't feel like it was going too slow or too fast. The pacing was perfect. Who cannot love the score for this movie? The score is really good. I don't know the composer's name. I probably should have written him down, but the composer is actually very good as well, and his score adds some tension to the film. There's actually surprisingly some really, really great effects in this film also. For instance, when the body is getting dragged in the hall, you guys, if you've seen it, you'll know what I mean. That is a really great effect that took a lot more than it looks like it took. And back then there was no CGI, so they had to do all this with trick photography and stuff. So it's insane how much effort they actually put into making this film. You wouldn't think that it would take that much, but it did. The ending, what can I say about the ending? I love this ending with a passion. Holy cow. so creepy, and it's kind of what, in my opinion, in movies, yeah, there's other movies, but to me, this is the quintessential mind flip ending. It's not as big of a mind flip as, say, Inception, but wow, your mind gets bent a lot at the very end. Not going to say much more about the ending because I just love it so much and I want you guys to experience it the same way that I did, not knowing anything about it. But let's just say you will get up and you'll be like, holy crap, what just happened? This movie, I do have a few problems with this movie. They're mostly nitpicks, but some of the acting in this film flat out sucks. And that's unfortunate. Luckily, most of it is just minor characters. But for instance, the mom in this movie irritates the heck out of me. The mom of Nancy irritates me so freaking much. And I don't know what it is. It might just be me, but I just do not like her acting. I also wanted more Freddy. Now, this is a nitpick for sure, but when you have a person like Robert Englund, and I know this is the first Freddy movie, so this is the first Freddy movie, but to me, he needed a little more time, and it's kind of unfortunate that we didn't get that as much time as I wanted. I just wanted maybe 10 more minutes of Freddy time, and I didn't get it, so it's kind of a bummer, but it is a nitpick, so it doesn't take away from the film by any means. It's just a personal preference for me. Anyway, A Nightmare on Elm Street, it's a really good movie. I'm giving it a B+ because it is one of the best horror movies of all time, but we cannot ignore a few of its faults. So anyway, once again, thank you 22 Tiger Dude for this opportunity. I love your channel so much. You make so many good videos, and props to you for letting me do this. This makes me like you as a person even more. Anyway, yeah, I'm going to be doing the same thing. I'm doing horror movies every day of the month, so check out my channel too if you want to check out my reviews. Anyway, see ya.
Thank you, Calob, for reviewing A Nightmare on Elm Street. So, A Nightmare on Elm Street is a horror classic. This is not only a classic, but one of the best horror films I've ever seen in my life. And this is also Johnny Depp's first film. And I gotta say, Johnny Depp, you made the right choice on picking this movie to start off your career. Good job to young Johnny Depp. And all of the actors here too. Heather Langenkamp, who plays the main girl of the movie, she does a terrific job here in the film, and I actually was really rooting for her character the whole time. She just did a terrific job with her character. Just the whole time I was really cheering for her. The cinematography for this movie looks really beautiful. Robert Englund plays Freddy Krueger and does a phenomenal job. The way he uses the claws and the makeup on his face, he looks really intimidating. Freddy creeps the shit out of me. I would not want to mess with Freddy at all. He's definitely one of the best horror slashers of all time. The writing was original. It was actually very well put together, and it was one of those very twisted horror films with very haunting imagery. And of course, the music. This has some of the best and most horrifying music you could ever hear in a horror film, period. I mean, the 1, 2, Freddy's coming for you. The concept of a slasher, but inside your own head, your own nightmares. I think that's very creative. Wes Craven, writing and directing it, he did a really great job, and I give a lot of credit to the guy for that. And it's because of him, he brought one of the best horror films I've ever seen. This movie is truly awesome. It had me engrossed from start to finish. It's what a lot of horror films should be. I honestly don't have any flaws with The Nightmare on Elm Street. This is a fantastic horror film, one of the best I've ever seen. So, of course, A Nightmare on Elm Street gets 4 out of 4 stars. It is perfect, loved, and adored every moment of this movie. And the ending, wow. Thank you, Calob, for guest starring here to review A Nightmare on Elm Street. He's a very cool dude. Please check out his channel. I will leave a link in the description below.